What's up, y'all? I said, what's up, y'all? Look at me when I'm talking to you, bro. Nah, I'm just messing with y'all, man. This is your boy Knockout Boxing 86 TV, and we in here. So check this out, bro. Before I get going on today's video, be sure to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel if you're new here, share the video, turn on your notification bell, and if you want me on the panel, knockoutboxing86@yahoo.com is the email address. But without further ado, let's get it popping and get into today's video. And today, we got to talk about the fights from this past weekend, man. So we predicted a total of four fights. We're going to recap the ones that we picked. First and foremost, we went 3-0. You probably wonder how we went 3-0 by predicting four fights, because we throw out our draws on this channel. We throw out our draws on this channel, so we had a record of 3-0. We got the Jose Valenzuela fight right, we got the Omar Juarez fight right, and we got the Malik Montgomery fight right. And we're going to talk about all of those fights right here in this video. But before we get into it, y'all don't forget about our live show that we do every Wednesday night, 7:30 p.m. Central Standard Time, 5:30 on the West Coast, 8:30 on the East Coast. And then we got our new show with the Singing OG, KQKC Boxing Network, the morning after show. We're going to do it every Sunday morning at 9 a.m. Central Standard Time. We're switching platforms. We did his platform last week, so y'all need to go subscribe to his channel so y'all will get his notifications. And then subscribe to my channel, because we're going to be on our platform, on my platform this week at 9 a.m. Central Standard Time. So y'all be sure to come through and hang out with your boy for a fun morning of boxing talk, where we talk about the hottest fights that just happened from the night before. And then we also cover some hot topics that's going on in the world of boxing at this time. But back into the video. So let's recap it, man. How did the weekend go? I thought it was a good couple of little cards going on, man. Some good free cards on FS1. You know what I'm saying? And I want to talk about it. So first and foremost, the Rajon Chance versus Alan DeJesus fight. I picked Rajon Chance to win that fight, and he lost, bro. He lost. Now, the ref scored a draw, so we throw it out on our record. But he lost that fight, in my opinion. I got to keep it a buck. I thought the ref did a horrible job. Rajon Chance got clearly caught with a hard shot. I believe that was the fourth round, where he got hurt really, really bad. And he started looking over to the ref, you know, looking for him to help him in the middle of a fight. And really should have called a TKO. They should have called it a TKO, because DeJesus clearly hurt him, clearly knocked him down. And they gave him, like, time to recover, let him go to the corner. He talking about, I can't see. Well, if you can't see, bro, that's where the ref got to be like, can you continue or can you not continue? And then you go from there. But overall, even without the knockout, DeJesus clearly landed the better shots. I thought Rajon Chance did very good the first couple of rounds of the fight. I feel like the third round was a swing round where you could score for Rajon Chance if you wanted to. But I thought from the middle of the third round through all the way through round six, DeJesus won that fight, in my opinion. And so for Rajon Chance, you know, young man, 21 years old, good speed. He got a lot to work on, though, man. His fundamentals are a little bit off. I thought he would have better fundamentals. He doesn't turn over his punches well. I wonder who he's been fighting to get those five knockouts that he's had, because his punching power doesn't seem to be there as he steps up in competition. And I think he realized in this fight, the amateurs and the pros and nothing alike. Now, you can see the talent, you can see the speed, you can see the reflexes, but he has a lot to work on. For DeJesus, keep grinding, bro. That punching power seems to be real down there in that weight class. Seems like he has good time and he has some good pedigree. So I underestimated him a little bit, and I felt like he should have got the victory. But all in all, they called it a draw. That was a very good fight. Another fight that we did, the Jose Valenzuela fight versus Berrio. That fight went exactly how we thought it would. You know, Valenzuela put on a very good performance. And I say very good, not great. And you're going to hear me say that a lot, because a great performance means you on all aspects of it. You on top of your shit offensively, defensively. You getting it done, and you're doing what you need to do in order to really shine on your opponent. He did enough to win. And it was what we thought it was. Berrio don't throw no punches, bro. He's a defensive-minded fighter to a fault. He's too defensively oriented. But the fights that the punches that I thought he would try to throw, he threw. I told y'all, if you go back and watch that fight, you go back and watch my prediction video, look, bro, Berrio going to be trying to land a wild-ass overhand right, and he's going to be trying to jump in with a left hook. Those are his punches. And if I knew it, and I'm just a boxing fan who, you know, tries to study fighters and do these predictions and try to get them right, then you would think that Jose Valenzuela and his corner would know that shit. But I don't know if he just didn't know it or isn't defensively sound enough, but he got hit with some punches that I ain't like, bro. He got hit with some punches against Barrio that I didn't like. Valenzuela is a very good offensive fighter. I love his activity offensively. I like his variety of punches. I like that he doesn't always throw at the same speed. But Valenzuela got to get out of this habit of using his offense as his defense. This shit ain't football, bro. This shit ain't football. It's boxing. In football, your offense can be your defense. You can score so many points that the other team just can't keep up. Not in boxing, bro. You can score as many points as you want to. If your defense ain't right and they catch your head with the right shot, you done lost the fight, bro. You done lost the fight. So Valenzuela still has a lot to work on defensively. Head is straight and on a line. Back straight up. Doesn't have very good head movement. And since he punches so much, he can get caught in between shots, bro. He can get caught in between shots. And he got to think, and his fans have to think, and his corner have to think, and people that really support him have to think, damn, if Barrio can catch him with those shots in between punches, what will a fighter that's more active with better time and better counterpunching ability, more willing to trade with him, more aggressive, what can they do with him? So I want to see him continue to improve, but overall, a very good performance from him. We got the dub in that instance. Another one that we predicted was the Omar Juarez fight. Omar Juarez was taking on Jairo Lopez. Thought he did a phenomenal job. I think this was the most complete performance. I didn't see him taking a lot of shots that were unnecessary. He dictated the tempo of that fight, landed like almost 100 more punches than Lopez did. And I like his variety on offense. He also shows an ability to switch his speeds, throw with power, throw with speed, continue to score points. But what I like about his performance over the Valenzuela performance, I think he was a little bit more defensively responsible. I didn't see his head getting popped back the way I saw Valenzuela's head get popped back. And he looked to have a little bit better feet, box off the back foot better. He walked his opponent into shots and countered them better than Valenzuela, in my opinion. But it's also because I think Omar Juarez was dealing with someone that was willing to trade with him, someone that was actually there to fight and not just survive and throw looping shots. So overall, though, Omar Juarez did what we expected him to do. He did his thing, bro. He did his thing. So congratulations to him and his corner and his supporters for getting the dub last night. The other one I want to talk about, man, it's the one that really, really was the best fight, in my opinion. It was the best fight. I think this was the biggest step up, and I think that, you know, Malik Montgomery showed that he a little bit different than most. He a little bit different. I liked a lot of things and I loved a lot of things, but there's some things that I think he needs to work on as well. First of all, shout out to his corner, Kenny Porter, was giving him great instructions. Malik Montgomery's biggest asset is that he a dog, bro. He's a dog's dog. He's a dog's dog, dog's dog. Like, Malik Montgomery wants to fight, bro. And his work rate is incredible, bro. Homie threw like 1,000-something punches. He throwing 100 punches around. So he going to be hard to outpoint. And to beat him, I think you're going to have to hurt him. You're going to have to hurt him. So knowing that, knowing he going to have a work rate, knowing that he going to put on, and salute to Aleem Jukmanov, bro. And I'm sorry if I'm saying your last name incorrectly. My Tajikistan brother. Tajikistan. Damn it, bro. I don't know. You know where you from. I apologize. But Jukmanov put on, bro. He provided great resistance. He was counterpunching. He was trying to keep up with Malik Montgomery. And he caught Malik Montgomery with some hard shots. But to Malik Montgomery's credit, being the dog that he is, he proved he got a chin, right? He proved he can outwork pretty much anybody, bro. Pretty much anybody. And so when you have those combinations, you put yourself in a position where dude's going to have to hurt you to beat you. Dude's going to have to hurt you to beat you. So what I want to see from Malik Montgomery, when he is boxing from a distance, man, he got a nice jab. He has good head movement. And so it's just him wanting to fight that gets him caught. It's him coming in to show you, like, you can't mess with him that gets him caught, in my opinion. Because when he's boxing, when he's aware, when he shows good head movement and good defense, bro. So For him, I want to see him get more systematic with dudes. Like, maybe work your way up to that work rate towards the back end of the fight. Spend the first part of the fight breaking dudes down, bro, using that great jab that you got. Countering, you know, catching people coming in. Break them down a little bit for the first three or four rounds. Then turn up the work rate on the ass. He just go one speed, 100 miles per hour from jump, does Malik Montgomery. Makes for a great fight to me. Makes for a great fight. That was the funnest fight to watch for the weekend because him and Jukmanov was getting it in, bro. We were seeing almost 200 punches a round from those two. They put on a barn burner, action-packed, hellfire fight. But Malik Montgomery outworked him, landed more shots, landed the cleanest shots, got the unanimous decision, as he should. I like that he got wobbled in the ninth round because we saw what he battled. Bro, he got caught with a hard-ass shot in the ninth round. Hard-ass shot in the ninth round, and he countered right back. You know what I'm saying? Responded to it well, so we know he got a chin. But I think game plan, strategy-wise, he know he in phenomenal shape. You know what I'm saying? Anybody that can throw that many punches in a fight, they in phenomenal shape. So keep that conditioning up. Continue to be able to use that work rate, but maybe break fighters down a little bit more first. You know what I'm saying? Maybe start off being more selective. Use that jab. You know what I'm saying? Get the eye messed up a little bit. Get the nose sweaty a little bit. That also jab. Start using the jab down to the body more. I saw it a couple of times, but he really aimed that jab up top, and it's a nice jab. Snap your head back jab. But start taking some air out of him with the jab down to the stomach. Following up with your power punches and shit behind the jab. Then work your way up to that aggressive ass work rate that you got. But overall, very good performance from him. I wouldn't call it a great performance because I want to see him get better defensively, bro. And by get better, I just think focus on it more. Because when he focuses on it, he showed it's there. Aleem couldn't hit him when he really didn't want to be hit. He couldn't hit him. But Malik Montgomery just such a dog, he won't get in there and fight. And shit, as a fight fan, and if you got a trainer or somebody who, you know, coaches kids on the side or whatever, you want to have to dial an athlete back. And so that's what I love about Malik Montgomery, bro. Like, you have to ask him to say, bro, maybe don't throw 100 punches. Maybe you work off your jab. Say, bro, you can counter him. He's not as fast as you. Why don't you do that and make the fight easier for yourself instead of going 100 miles per hour the whole damn time? You know what I'm saying? I'd rather have to do that than try to tell the fighter, look, bro, you got to be more aggressive. Look, bro, you need to really go in and you need to try to throw more punches. He's outworking you right now. You ain't never got to worry about nobody outworking Malik Montgomery, bro. You don't. And that's something that's dangerous, bro. He didn't get the knockout because he was dealing with a tough customer, but very good performance. So overall, 3-0 this week. With one draw, we back on the undefeated streak. You know what I'm saying? We about to get it going. We got a big card coming up this weekend. So y'all know we're going to do that card. We are now 103 right with 21 wrong. I told y'all, by the time I get to 200 right, I want to have close to a 90% correct rate. That's a lofty-ass goal if you do the numbers. That means I really can't miss no more. I got to get like 97 in a row. Probably not possible, but you know your boy going to try. You know your boy going to try. But so y'all stay tuned, man. Breakdowns and fight predictions, regular basis around here every week. We got some big-ass cards coming up, so y'all going to get a lot of them. Y'all going to get a lot of them. We got them set up as a playlist on the channel because I purposely want y'all to be able to go back to all my breakdowns and all my predictions, see where I was right and see where I was wrong in case you ever think I'm lying about my record and how successful we've been so far. But overall, man, great weekend of fights. I'm really looking forward to this weekend. Got a heavyweight unified championship fight coming up that your boy going to break down and get into for you. So plus the entire card. Some people ask me, am I going to do the Coley fight? Yes. Am I going to do the Callum Smith fight? Yes. And we're going to find some other fights to do too on that card, man. But y'all let me know down in the comment section what y'all thought of this weekend. Comment down below. Hit the like. Subscribe to the channel. Share the video. Turn on your notifications. And if y'all want me on the panel, knockoutboxing86@yahoo.com. Don't forget about our live shows every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. Central Time. And then our co-host show that we do with the singing OG KQKC Boxing Network. Go subscribe to his channel. That's KQKC Boxing Network. Subscribe to his channel so you know when we live on his platform. And obviously subscribe to my channel so you know when we live on my platform. We do our morning after boxing show every Sunday morning, 9 a.m. Central Standard Time. So y'all tune in for that. It's going to be right here on my platform this Sunday. So y'all come through and show some love, man. I appreciate y'all watching the video. Enjoy the rest of your day. And with that, we out of here, y'all. Peace.